Welcome to the Tug and Mule Show. I'm Tug.
And I'm Mule. This video is intended for entertainment and educational purposes only. Please contact your local representative regarding contractual language and contractual rights. All opinions expressed in this video.
The light's like. It's a spooky show.
All opinions expressed in this video are our own and do not reflect that of our employer. All opinions shared in this video are protected under the National Labor Relations Act. Thank you.
So today's show might be a little long. We have a lot of stuff to cover.
It's not going to be that long.
It is. It's going to be a little long. It's just because we have a lot of stuff to cover.
I will try and keep her on track.
And we haven't done a show for a while. So we have a lot of stuff we need to cover. So, and it looks like it's going to be a spooky show because the lights are going up and down. Don't get scared now. Okay. So, we're going to go back a little bit and we are going to cover the rallies out here and we went to
two rallies out here.
We did. We went to our rally here at Local 63. And then we also went to the 952 rally that where Sean spoke.
And you all, if you have the UPS Teamsters app, you went in and saw it online.
Yep.
So.
So we're going to just briefly cover some pictures that we thought were really cool from the 952 one. But we would like to cover, show some pictures and a video from the rally. Just what we have an actual 50 minute video from the we can do that one. That's one for you. We have a 50 minute video from the actual rally at our local, but we're only going to show you one clip from that. Because I don't think you guys need to watch 50 minutes. It's kind of long.
Kind of.
So if anybody wants to see it, I can send it over to you. So this was the 952 rally. This picture I took because I thought this was really awesome. So this particular member, Sean had done something particularly important for him, and he made a point to go up there. Sean was really busy that day and he was going to have to take off right away after the meeting, but he made a point to go up there and thank Sean. And Sean took time out of the really busy schedule to talk to him. And I didn't hear all the conversation because it really was none of my business. But what I did catch of it, I really thought that this moment was super awesome and I really wanted to capture it in photo because I just loved that Sean would take that moment out for that member. And these guys are some guys that we met from 542 and they're just super awesome Teamsters that have been working really hard down there to get their members involved and really just bringing a really great group together. And are doing a lot down there for all their members down there. So this is a sign that this guy had from the original 1997 strike. And we thought that that was really cool. This is actually from the 63 rally. Randy Corgan was there with Randy K. Mack and they spoke. This is another one from the actual 63 rally. Our rally was not at our local. It was actually out in front. This is the Ontario building. This is gate 7 where we all enter. And that's where they had the rally there. And this is back. This is the 63 rally as well. And so this is back at 952. Christine and I took some pictures of some really cool t-shirts.
I really love this one.
Yeah. So we got some really awesome t-shirts. So this was the Ready to Fight for Our Contract. United we bargain, divided we beg. They had some really cool shirts. So Christine had to get a picture with this
Katie Porter. She's a congresswoman. She's I believe, in the House of Representatives. So
Christine was super excited that she was there.
I was.
All right. And the gentleman to Christine's, so it would be her left, right. That is Hugo. He is awesome. He's actually from 396. I have known him for years. He is a great, just great active teamster. Been fighting for years. I love Hugo. He's a great guy. That is a great picture. That is an awesome shirt. That shirt is going to be available soon to buy. When on our next show, we'll be letting you guys all know where you can get our merch and start buying stuff. That's another really cool shirt. We just really liked a lot of the shirts that were available out there. That was actually from the campaign, but we thought that shirt was really cool. And that is just a really great photo of Sean. And
this is back to our 63. This is
the 63, yeah. And then this was the United in 97, United Today. That is a really cool shirt from the guys in 542. And then this is just a bunch of the guys at the 542 one. And there's our mule right this there in the middle.
At 952.
Our 952, yeah.
Oh, and that's it.
Yeah, that's all.
That's all of our pictures from the rallies that we went to, and we saw Sean, and we watched him speak, and I really enjoyed that.
That was a really, yeah, no, that one, the one in 952 was really awesome. The energy there was amazing. The members were just really behind the whole thing. It was just, the speakers there were amazing. They had people from LA Trade Tech. They had Congresswoman, like Christina said. They had various local leaders there. It was just all together. There was a lot of locals that came out. There was a lot of different members there. It was just a really good.
A lot of 396 people.
Yeah.
Out there supporting Victor Mineros, who spoke.
542 was there. Yeah, it was a really awesome day. Like we had a really good time.
Yep.
We would like to share.
Today I'm here as a rank and file. I'm not here as an advisory board member because I'm a member just like anyone here. I see multiple generations, and it's our turn. You know, when this company, when we had this last contract, the company made $4.8 billion in 2018. And 3 years ago, I was told that I was a hero, that I was essential, that I was needed.
That's right.
And they needed me. And then over that time, it didn't feel like I was needed. It felt like it reverted back. It reverted back to, you know, put the pressure on. You're not needed. You're just another number. And we're tired of it. We are tired of feeling that way. So now is the time. Now is the time to stand up. And we're all here because we want to stand up. But the ones that aren't here, you need to tell them. You should have been here. You need to be active. It is our responsibility as members. Like David said, it's not the business agent's responsibility. It's ours as members, because ultimately we're the ones who are going to vote on this contract. So you need to be active. Tell your friends, this is what's going on. Be involved. Know what's going on at all times. And it starts today, being here and knowing. Thank you.
For those that don't know me, I'm a local 63 feeder steward. I'm on the advisory board. I appreciate the fact to be able to work with the advisory, with the e-board, doing things. Right now I'm going to have my good friend Ed Reynoso come up here. For those of you who don't know, Eddie was the lead steward out here in 1997. And when we did the strike, I left my house Monday morning, and I did not go home and hit my bed till Wednesday night that week. I came out here, I was working at the Riverside building. I picketed there Monday, came here, picketed Monday night, picketed back at Riverside on Tuesday, came back here on Tuesday night, and at the end of that night, I told my good friend here, Eddie, I'm not coming back. And he said, why? I'm gonna concentrate on Riverside, because if I keep coming here, you're gonna get me killed or get me fired. So, and what happened, Eddie?
Kicked ass.
And who got fired?
twice.
So, Jim already alluded to it earlier. All the 22 threes, all the sleeper language that we now have is because of that 97 contract. Okay. On that third Monday, the first Monday after not getting a paycheck, the company expected 50% of the workforce to cross the picket line that day. On that third Monday. By the end of that third Monday of the strike, less than 2% of the workforce had crossed the picket line.
So
we don't want anybody. Everybody needs to support. Don't listen to the lies. Listen to the truth. Listen to your stewards. Listen to your business agents. Go to them to find out what's going on with the contract and with the strike, okay? Hopefully there won't be a strike, but if there is, everybody needs to walk the picket line, respect the line, and not cross the line.
Yeah!
Thank you very much.
Moving on.
So we wanted to also revisit the chicken caper, because we have an update on our chickens. Because we know everybody is just super excited about the chickens. So, the chickens have been named Rose, Blanche, Dorothy, Sophia, and Stan, because we have five. And anybody who is familiar with where all these names come from knows that the ex-husband is Stan. we are building a new coop currently, and it will probably be the Fluffy Butt Hut. It was going to be the Slut Hut, but we changed our mind since we don't have a rooster. That is
Rose.
Yes, this is Rose. She is so dumb. You can see it in her eye.
You can see it in her eye.
She's really stupid. That's Stan. He is the man.
He's the black-headed stepchild in there.
Yeah. But she lays two very beautiful eggs. She's our Easter egger, and she'll lay green, pink, blue, different colored eggs. So but she usually lays about two a day. She's our biggest, and she does rule that coop. This is Dorothy.
I love Dorothy.
She's adorable. That's Sophia, and boy, is she a loud bitch. She knows what she wants. And
she doesn't shut up.
She Start doesn't shut finish. Up. Yeah, she's loud. She's fun. And that's Blanche. And if we had a rooster, she would definitely be Blanche. And these are our eggs. These are some of our eggs that we've gotten. And you can't really tell, but those are actually, the ones in the middle are actually like green. So it's kind of hard to tell on that picture, but yeah, they're actually green. They're not white. We don't have any white eggs.
Okay.
So
those are our chickens. We've decided that that's what we've named them.
Yes.
Thank you for being a friend.
Travel down the road and back again.
Your heart is true.
You're a pal and a confidant. Okay.
Sorry. That was our Golden Girls moment. I'm getting more senior moments by the day.
Right. Okay. So moving on to something more current. I think we do this one.
Do we do that one? I don't know. Can't we do this one? Maybe not. I guess not.
Well, I think we can if we're going to talk about... No, I don't even see it in there.
No.
No.
Nope. I guess not.
No, these are all just photos.
Yeah.
No.
Yep, you were right.
Whoa.
What the hell did you do now?
I guess I shared that.
I don't know that that's shared. No, it's not.
Okay.
Let's try this again. Microphone off. No, leave it. Shared device audio.
Are they going to hear us?
They'll hear us because they're
okay. All right, so we want to go here. So this is your the actual IBT Constitution. And in
Article 12.
section one. Well, actually starts way up here. But we just want you to, in this section one, down in here, it actually, where did I lost?
Doesn't there matter. She's
down here. Section two, it talks about, so the one above this talks about your, like, your white papers, your local contracts, and then it gets into your area mutual or your or national contracts, which was going to apply to the UPS contracts. The reason why we're showing you this is because there's been a lot of talk about when you're going to see your contract. When are you going to see the language that's being negotiated? Okay. This is really the stuff that we wanted to talk about today. So you really want to start reading this stuff because it talks about upon completion of the negotiation and committee, this is when you're going to start seeing your language. Once the national is gotten a tentative agreement, then they will actually send out the supplements and the national language to everybody before you actually vote. And then on top of that,
we have a meeting.
Yeah.
We have a meeting.
Every joint council and local will start having meetings. And
you have to attend. Trust me, it's not a fun meeting. You're not going to be partying. And
no, and they're long, but they're very, very important. They will go over every single article that has gotten language change in it. Even if it's a minute one word, they will go over that article and tell you what word was changed, what words were taken out, what words were added, how it was changed. And you need to be in that meeting so that you can know what was changed. Any proposals that you've written or you've submitted, take those with you. Take notes, have notes with you so that you know which articles you're looking for that may or may not have been changed so that you can be aware of what you wanted changed or so that you know what's going on. Okay. You guys are wanting to know how this whole process works. And this is why Christine and I are doing this so that we can let you guys know how this whole process works so that everybody's not stressing out right now. So if you go down a little further, I believe it's in section C in here. It also talks about how the actual voting process works.
It just explains that even if the national is passed, even if we say yes to the national, if your supplements and riders are not complete, then it doesn't start. It doesn't take effect until everything is done.
The contract is not ratified.
So until they ratify all of it, then we wait. And whatever monetary incentives we have to pass it, you'll get a retro check. You'll get it when the contract ratifies.
So if it goes beyond August 1st and there isn't a strike for whatever reason, then you start going into retro checks, which is what happened last time. If Sean and Fred decide that because it was voted down and we're going to strike, then we can strike on it. But that's all stuff that's got to come later. And this is all stuff that's going to happen based on how we're going to vote on the contract. And in here, it talks about a strike vote. And it explains how the whole process works. And this is why it is so important for you guys to read your constitution so that you can really understand how this process works. How does a strike vote work? How does it work if a supplement is voted down? How does it work if the national is voted down and supplements pass, or the national is passed and the supplements are voted down? It explains all of this to you so that you can understand all of this language, so that you are prepared to understand what is happening, what is actually going on at negotiations right now, what is happening, what are they doing, and why is the process the way that it is, so that it doesn't feel like you're being left out, because in a lot of ways you're not. It's just how the process works.
It's how the process works, and it's how involved you get into finding out what's going on. So you can't just rely on word of mouth or social media. Be at the meeting. Be prepared to be there a couple hours. Be prepared to take notes. Be prepared to ask questions. These are important meetings. And I don't say that about all meetings, but these are important.
And if you're not happy with the language that was negotiated, then let everybody know. You can go out there and say that this is why you're not happy, but specify why you're not happy. Don't just say, I'm voting no because I'm not happy. You need to say, I'm voting no, because in Article 4, I wanted this specific language and I didn't get it. So, you know, or, you know, I wanted the wage increase to be exactly this. I wanted, you know, part-timers to get this and this year and this year, this year, this year, and full-timers to get this and this kind of a bump. And because this specific language wasn't there, I'm going to go ahead and vote no. You need to be specific to the language as to what that language was not, as to why you're not, or come out and put a flyer and say, this is why I'm voting yes, because I got this language, and this language, and it is so great that this is why I believe we should support the contract. You need to always have language, and I've said this for years to the BAs out here, when they come out and they tell members to vote yes on a contract, you want the members to vote yes for something, tell them why. What is the language in there that you believe is so good for them to vote yes? Because we have language to support why we should be voting no.
Or yes. If we're going to...
Well, we haven't voted yes ever. So this will be the first time for us. So I'm not saying we don't know how we're going to vote, but I'm saying if we vote yes this time, this will be the first time we've ever voted yes, because the contracts since Hoff and Hall have been in office and been garbage.
Well...
this will be a new thing for us,
right? So we did hear that that some things have gotten tentative agreements, as far as I know.
Yes.
And I don't know. You probably can't share those either, huh?
Yeah. That'd be the same thing, though, I would think.
Yeah, I think so.
So most of you have probably already seen this. This is the contract update that they put out. They spoke about this today, if you were on the webinar with Fred Zuckerman. So they talked about the no 5 and 1, 5 and 7. So if you're not familiar with what exactly that means, basically, and UPS, I know, wanted this in the last contract as well. But they were pushing for it really hard this time. And I am so glad that Sean and Fred said no, because basically what that meant was UPS wanted basically for you to come in on a Monday to Tuesday, you're off Wednesday, you come back Thursday, you're off Friday, and then you work Saturday and Sunday, or any combination of that insanity.
Right.
And I'm very glad that they said no to that. Because
we're getting overtime for part-timers,
and
something we pushed for.
Yeah. And we're going to review that on in a minute, because Christine and myself and a great guy from 396, Lawrence Cruz, have been working on that exact proposal for years. Grievance reform, that is another proposal that Lawrence and I had been working on for years. Seniority and bidding for preferred jobs. The preferred job language, Lawrence and I was able to put into the supplement out here in the last contract. Thank God. I don't know what the seniority language that they're referring to out here is. We did put in a proposal out here, Christine and I, for seniority language for part-timers, but we're not sure what the seniority is, so we really don't want to speak to that yet. The preferred job language, we believe that they're talking to what we already have out here, and basically what that is whether you're a part-timer or a full-timer, like a 22-3, if you work inside the building, and you've been there like 6 months, or you've been on your job as a combo for, this is just 30 days.
No, 6 months.
Okay. Then you can prefer job out. So if you're loading trailers, or you don't like your small sort job, or you don't like whatever job you have, you can take what is called a preferred job. So you can go to HR, fill out the preferred job paper. And well, that's where you get we still have offices that are called HR rooms, and there's no one in there, but they have little boxes outside of them.
Okay.
There's no people, but there's little racks outside of them that have papers in our building. And so you have to go get the, so that's where we refer people to the old HR room where you get the paper that you fill out. It's where you get your preferred job paper, part-time to full-time paper, all those papers that you go to the old HR room. And because it's a rack that I don't know who puts stuff in the racks, but magically the racks are full of papers.
Somebody does it.
So
the little munchkins.
Yes.
The lollipop guild.
The lollipop guild.
Yeah, okay. It's magic. The shit just appears.
But yeah, we fill out the preferred job. So you can go from loading a trailer
to belt tending.
To like belt tending or small sword or bulk.
We're back to bugs.
And I'm sorry.
It's attacking my leg.
Sorry.
Just go.
Bugs.
My favorite.
Anybody in California that has like a studio anywhere near where we live, you don't need it.
Yeah, right. Who doesn't need it? Okay. And as of now, we have not given any concessions to the company, which is also a new thing for us.
That's a whole new territory.
It's a whole new world, man.
This is probably why the company's been getting up and walking out of meetings.
Okay.
So, because they're like, bullshit, where's my concession pie?
You're not getting them this time. Okay, what's next?
So we just wanted to really quick share with you so that you guys understood where'd it go?
The files, wasn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, okay. So one of the things that they talked about was grievance machinery, which is basically the new grievance language. And one of the proposals that Lawrence and I had been putting in for the last 20 years.
Four contracts.
Yeah. It's language that we actually took out of the local 705. And we actually have attached the full language. We don't know if they got the full language, but we do know that this is one part that they have talked about being in the actual supplements, which is in discharge and suspension cases, an impartial arbitrator should hear the case alongside the UPS and Teamster panel members and cast the deciding vote in the event of a deadlock. So we know that there will now be arbitrators at our grievance hearings. This is a huge win. And I know a lot of people don't like this idea, but this is huge.
This speeds up the process.
Oh, this is
so you're not sitting waiting for years or many, many, many months to get your job back if something should happen, and or you're put on suspension for whatever reason. These things get heard much more quickly in this process than you would normally have to go through with our current process.
Yeah, we have hundreds of cases that are just backlogged in the grievance system out here, and this would eliminate so much of that. And this would eliminate thousands and thousands of dollars being spent by your local paying for an arbitrator, because arbitrators are insanely expensive.
Yes.
And this would eliminate a lot of that, where that money could go to, I don't know,
Todd's salary.
Okay. She said it, not me.
Don't I always?
Yeah, but then I get yelled at.
They don't yell at me. They don't yell at me. They yell at you. So anyway.
Strike funds. It could go to strike funds.
God forbid we have a strike fund.
It could go to education.
Where's
bringing in educators from TDU?
Yeah, it's right here. It's right here. Part-time guarantees.
Yes. So this is another one that we wrote.
We're not sure what the language
is. We do not know exactly. I am hearing rumors that the language is at the sixth hour. I don't care if it's the fifth hour or the sixth hour.
And I'm not sure if the guarantee is going to change at all.
And we don't know if you're getting a four-hour guarantee.
This is the proposal that we put in at the proposal meeting. This does not mean this is right.
No. But we're just showing you an example of the kind of proposals that we put in. And they did give us something similar to this, but we have to wait until our meeting to find out exactly what's in the language. But one of the reasons why we're showing you this is because this is the kind of stuff that you're going to see at the meeting. When you go to your meeting and they give you your contract, you're going to see this is how the language is going to look. So they're going to cut out like some parts of the old language and they're going to have filled in the new language.
And this is, I remember this from last time. I don't remember much, but I remember this. This is how it looks. The bold is the new, what's crossed off is the old. And that's how these work. That's what you'll see when you go into these meetings. So you're not going to see a book like our contract and say you have to go through that. No, we're going to go through and we're going to say, okay, so Article 5, no changes. And if you don't know what Article 5 is or whatever article they're referring to, go into your contract and look it up and say, well, why didn't we change this? We should have changed something here. This needed to be fixed. So pay attention to these things and you get a copy of them when you go to the contract proposal, the contract meeting with the local. They I remember they handed out booklets kind of things.
Yes.
So I mean, pay attention.
Yep. And this is why years ago Lawrence and I started writing the proposals in this format, because this is actually how they're submitted at negotiations. So that there's no
confusion
or dispute when it comes to one side or the other. You know, they know exactly what's coming out, exactly what's going in, and how it is to be written in the contract. And they can hash out whatever they want changed from there.
I think that was all we were going to deal with right now.
Yeah, we have a lot of other ones Weekly Punch, but we're not sure about that one. So let's not.
We've heard rumors.
Yeah, we've heard rumors that the Weekly Punch may or may not change.
For your health insurance. And please remember that I know you don't, if some of you don't feel like this affects you. You know, you're a part-timer. You've been there 2 years. You don't plan on staying for the rest of your life like some of us.
We never did. A lot of us have college degrees. We had no intentions on being there forever.
Exactly. So what you intend when you're 20 and what happens in life, two different things. And that's why we haven't put out a show, because life has gotten in the way. And I apologize because it's mostly my life that's gotten in the way. But neither here nor there. Please remember that retirees don't vote. Okay. They still have the benefits of their pension and their health care, but we vote on that for them. So if you don't think it's important for you, fine. Well, think about me, who's been there 20 years. And when I want to retire, I would really appreciate it if you kept me in your thoughts when you're voting. Because if they put in some really stupid language, like an increase in the premium that you have to pay when you retire, you know, 400%, I'm up the creek, let me tell you. So pay attention. And some of the things that we do or do not get, remember, you have to look at the big picture. Okay, there's the healthcare that they're going to talk about. They're going to talk about your pension. I know you young kids don't think that's important. Trust me, I didn't when I started there. It's important. Okay, as I age every year over many years, I think it's become more of an important thing for me. So that as I'm getting closer to that place where I can say, no, I'm done. I hope that other people will think of me when they're voting for contracts, because I think of them. I have friends who have retired and I hear their stories of how much they pay for their health insurance and what they're getting out of their pension and their 401k and all those things. I hear those stories, and while it doesn't affect me today, it will affect me tomorrow. So we would really appreciate you keep that in mind when you're voting. Please vote when it comes time. And we'll tell you how we're going to vote. That's not a
problem. And we'll tell you why. We'll give you specific language as to why we're voting the way we're voting. We will do a show and let you guys know the reasons why we vote the way we're going to vote. But today we cannot tell you today how we are going to vote because we have not seen the language. They're not done negotiating it. So there's no way that either one of us can give you a decision on how we're voting. We don't know. And she's one of the big reasons is exactly what she said. We don't know the pension language or the healthcare language for not only us, but for the retirees. That is really important to us because we are pretty close to being retiree. And we have friends that are retirees and we have to vote for them. So
unfortunately,
I'm closer than she is.
Just the old bitch.
So unless I take over the local.
Okay.
What a way to end the show.
Remember, the best place to look for new information is the UPS Teamsters app. Please join the webinars that they have. I believe they've been having them monthly.
Yes.
Since February.
Yep.
And
there's a training class. There is a training class coming in June.
Okay.
I think it's June. I want to say it's June 18th at Local 396. That is the local one for out here.
Okay.
That's the closest one. I know there's going to be one in like Vegas and there's one in Arizona, but for us locally out here, it's 396. Yeah. Vegas. Yeah. Maybe that's what we should do is plan a big trip for all of us. Just to go to the one in Vegas.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Have our locals send us.
Yeah, no, that won't happen. That'd be that money they're saving on arbitration. Okay, so.
I won't comment.
Thank you. I appreciate that. All right, anything else we need to cover today?
I don't think so.
We're a little discombobulated. It's been a while.
It hasn't. It was, we had a lot planned for the show. So I think we covered everything. But if we didn't, then
we'll make another episode.
We'll shoot something short and I'll throw it in there.
We'll try. Working on it.
Because I can edit really well, but our videos don't always turn out good because you got this little light and shit going on and the sound sometimes is crap. And
yeah, sometimes we have people walk by and cars come in.
Yeah.
Bugs fly in
and
my head.
And the music is awful now. I don't know what the hell's going on.
Right? Shit.
Your blood is fine, your mind is too. Just watch your mouth, I'll sit on you. The word is out, better treat me right. Cause I'm the king
of cellulite.
Come on, I'm gonna be
so sorry.
That's it for the last. I'm not afraid.
Yeah.
I'm too much man
for you to take.
The pavement cracks when I'm on the turn. I've got more chance than some can. I never used the phone first, and I never seen my toes. When I'm going to the movies, I ain't no fan of the movies. I'm back, I'm back. 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 I